What is up, YouTube? Matt with Chrome Donkey here for another video. So what are we doing today? I wanted to do a real quick review on the decked cargo system that I recently installed. So these things you can get brand new off of the decked website, but they're quite expensive. Sometimes these things can go for around $1,200, $1,300. Definitely depends on the vehicle. Definitely was not willing to spend that kind of money on this cargo system, but Facebook Marketplace to the rescue. So I set out and looked for one of these on Facebook Marketplace, and as luck would have it, I found a guy who recently bought a Gladiator, so it was essentially brand new, and he did not want the deck system. He needed more use of the actual bed, so he was willing to let it go at a pretty steep discount. So I got this installed for $800. So what are we looking at? So essentially, you can do, you know, all kinds of things with the decked cargo system. It's got a 2,000 pound payload capacity, which is actually more than the Gladiator anyway. So anything that you would normally be able to carry in the bed, you can simply carry on top of the deck system. If you can see, it's got really high-end caster wheels. So when you open this, the drawers are just super smooth and they come all the way out. So they're actually full length drawers. So you don't lose any depth of the bed with regards to the drawers. You can pick up some of these dividers, and I got a couple of the dividers from the website, as well as their boxes that are designed to go in these channels. Now, I will say these boxes are super heavy duty. They're weatherproof, they're waterproof, they've got gaskets inside, so you're not getting any dust or water inside those boxes. And you can really orient this however you want. I mean, you can do two of those boxes on this thin channel. You've got some bigger ones over here on the bigger side. As you can see, I've got those. The other thing to point out is notice how there's weather stripping here on the drawers. So this is really nice, keeping all the weather, the dust, the rain, the water out of the drawers. So they are essentially waterproof. And I've got this nice little organizer here that I've got some things in, such as, you know, my life straw if I ever had to have it, my receiver hitch lock, and a couple other little odds and ends. I've also got one of their bigger boxes here that I've got some random stuff in, and these actually go pretty deep in there. So if you can see that blanket, that's actually a packing blanket. I've got that in there in case I ever need to haul anything that I don't want to get scuffed or scratched. And literally, you just close them and they close shut. So real simple. I really love the setup. Now, it is anchored in the four corners. Now, this is something that you might want to take note of, because if you look on their website, it's a little misleading because it looks like there's four J hooks in the corners, and there are on some of the bigger vehicles, but not these short beds, these smaller setups. You'll notice that on some of the bigger trucks, you also have equal drawer sizes. On the Gladiator, you'll see that you've got, you know, a thinner drawer as well as the typical full width drawer. So keep that in mind when you're talking about cargo. You can see the J hook right in here. So those of you who have the 110 plug, you know, in the corner of the bed, real simple, you just install the dongle that'll just lay right here so you can still have access to that. One thing that you'll note is it does pretty much restrict all your bed LED lights like mine. You can see that it's just barely sticking out here above, which is a little annoying. I would, you know, really like to have the bed lit up, but it's not really that big a deal. And you can see the J hook there. That's how it anchors in the back. Now in the front, obviously I'm not going to be able to show you this because it's hidden behind here, but notice how there's these four bolts. And essentially what you've got below this deck that you can't see is a bracket that attaches to the bed wall where the OEM tie downs are. So this is actually a really nice way that I move these OEM anchor points up to the top. This is where the tonneau cover would originally connect, and those are good and secure. But you have to remove these from the bed of the truck and install brackets. So one of the things I wanted to point out is if you ever want to take this system out, it's not as easy as undoing the J hooks in the corners and lifting it vertically and moving it out of the truck. You actually have to disassemble the whole thing. There's some bolts that run down through the center channel. There's those four I showed you up top. You have to take the drawers out. So it's a little bit of an involved process. You do have the ammo cans here. These are an additional nice little storage area. Now, I will say the ammo cans are definitely not water and weatherproof, so you will have to, you know, whatever you put in there, you'll have to be cognizant that could get some water, could get some dust in there. And the other thing you can add, you can add some locks to the drawers, but here's the thing, with the tailgate up, for those of us who have a locking tailgate, I mean, you can't really get to the drawer, but you can open it as far as there. So maybe if you had some valuables, just don't store them right there at the tip of the drawer. But you're definitely not getting those drawers out as long as your tailgate is locked. So for me, you know, I really love this setup, and I've also got, let me show you guys this as we go back inside. Take you on a brief tour here of the home office. But I also have, this is my rig, my computer home office rig, but I also have this, and I'll leave a link in the description. And essentially this is a giant spider web, and I've also got some carabiners here. So I've got four carabiners with this giant spider web. And so the idea there is, if I ever need to carry anything on top of the deck system that I don't want falling out, I can simply use that spider web netting, use those carabiners at the four corners and anchor it so that I can still actually carry cargo without worrying about it falling over the sides of the truck. So definitely highly recommended if you can find it at a discount. Me personally, I can't justify paying, you know, that kind of money for one brand new. But for those of you who need trunk, you know, or bed cargo organization space, honestly, that's one of the best ways to go. So just my quick thoughts on the deck system. I definitely love it. You know, you can obviously see my spare tires on top of it now. Probably gonna look for an alternative way to carry that in the near future. But anyway, thanks so much for stopping by. If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to the channel. We're gonna be doing some more cool stuff with the Jeep. Like the video if you found it informative, and you know, leave a comment. I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments. Thanks so much for stopping by. Stay safe, stay healthy, and we'll see you guys on the next video.